Today's episode, Tsealing the Tsar Bell. Gumshoes. Carmen Sandiego and her confederacy of con artists have struck again. This time, they KO'd Moscow's ancient walled fortress, the Kremlin. The belfry and bell tower of Ivan the Great are the tallest structures in the Kremlin. What's inside the belfry? Bells! 21 richly ornamented bells hang in the tower, and one more sits on a stone pedestal at the bottom. That's the big guy, the Tsar Bell. Cast in the 1730s, it weighs more than 200 tons and is decorated with images of Russian royalty, a Tsar and Tsarina. It's the largest chimer in the world, and you'd think it would stay put, but no. When irresistible force meets immovable object, something's gotta give. What gave? The bell at the base. Eartha Brute broke in and stole the Tsar Bell. Gumshoes, your mission is to bring in Eartha, ring in the bell, and ding out Carmen Sandiego once and for all. The treasure's been caught, and the crooks must be stopped.
Where in the world is
Carmen Sandiego?
And none of these people could find her.
Zeb Kendros. Nirav Bias. William Walker.
And this man is special agent in charge of training new recruits, Fred Lee.
Thanks very much. Hi, guys, how are you? Good enough. Okay, you've heard about the case. We're going to start you off now with 50 Acme Crime Bucks. Anytime you answer a question correctly, we'll give you 10 more Crime Bucks. And the two of you with the highest score at the end of this round will then proceed to the next round. And as always, all of our answers have been verified by National Geographic World.
National Geographic World.
Thank you so much. Chief, let's go.
Greg, Eartha Brute has stolen the Tsar Bell, and there's no time to lose. Here's the profile on Eartha.
Eartha Brute, Eartha Brute.
A tall, troublesome tower whose belfry is bereft of brains. And here's what we know so far. Eartha took the bell to the homeland of another ancient monarchy, the kings of Siam. She dragged it into Isawantapaya'a, an island pavilion where the royals escaped from the hot Bangkok summers. The pavilion, which appears to be floating on the lake, is one of the most photographed structures in the country. Now, on the grounds, you'll also find a topiary garden where all the bushes have been trimmed into the shape of elephants. But be alert. It will be hard to pick Eartha out in this crowd. Greg.
Thanks, Gumshoes. Okay, guys, to what country did Eartha go? Is it Thailand, Myanmar, or Bangladesh? Remember the clues that we heard? The ancient monarchy of the kings of Siam and Bangkok. Zeb's ready, so is William, and Nirav is now ready. Zeb, what do you say?
I say Thailand.
Thailand. Nirav, what do you think?
I chose Thailand.
Thailand. William.
I chose Thailand.
Thailand. The answer we're looking for is Thailand. Nice job, guys. Yeah, you guys do that one. Okay, so Zeb, you have 60. Nirav, you have 60. William, you have 60. Nice job, guys. Give us some time. Now we'll find out about you. Zeb, tell me about yourself.
I play bass for a group, Jackal. Two people are over there. Okay, and that's about it.
Good enough, okay. Nirav, how about you?
I play basketball, and I like to ski and water. I like swimming.
Good. Okay, William?
I'm a baritone sax player, and I recently took a trip to Spain and England.
Very good. You guys have a great time today. Please welcome them all to the show, if you would, please. All right, you guys are off to a great start. Everybody has 60 crime bucks. Here comes our next clue. I understand we have a hot tip from Acme Poochnet. Take a look.
Good day, mate. We saw your Eartha, all right, dragging a big bell behind.
It's big, all right. Behind, that is. She's in a city not far from the Great Australian Bight. That's part of the continent that looks like somebody chomped a piece out of it.
She took a Popeye boat up the Torrens River to the zoo here and hid out.
She's got no manners, that one. Kept grabbing the food right out of the wallaby's mouth.
She's a bonza babe, all right. Fair dinkum.
Thanks, Pouchnet. Okay, guys, name the Australian city, if you will, please. Is it Kew, Hobart, or Adelaide? Remember the clues that we heard? City near the Great Australian Bight and Torrens River. Okay? Everyone's still coming up with an answer as quickly as you can, guys. Trying to find Eartha and the bell. Everybody's ready. Zeb, what do you say?
I say Adelaide.
Adelaide, what do you think, Nirav?
I say Adelaide.
Adelaide, William.
I say Kew.
Q, the answer we're looking for is Adelaide. Nice job, Zeb and Nero. All Okay, Zevin, you got to 70. William has 60 crime bucks now. Acme CrimeNet is now reporting that Eartha is in Nigeria, so that's going to change some things. Okay, you guys know what that means? It means it's time for the lightning round, which means all of these questions are about Eartha's most recent known whereabouts, which is Nigeria. Each correct answer is worth 5 crime bucks. Hands on your buzzers. Listen carefully. Here we go. We said that the Yoruba were one of the ancient peoples who populated Nigeria. Which of the following is not a group that lives in Nigeria? The Fulani, the Hausa, or the Navajo? Zeb.
The Navajo.
Navajo is right. Nice job. 5 for you. Takes up to 75 crime bucks. Question 2. Nigeria ranks 14th in the size on the continent of Africa. Does it have Africa's largest population, largest desert, or longest river? Nirav.
Longest river.
Sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Zeb.
Largest population.
Largest population's right. Nice job. 5 for you. Question number 3. Lagos is currently the capital city of Nigeria, but a new capital is being readied in the central part of the country. Is that city called Ankara, Albany, or Abuja? William.
Ankara.
Sorry, it's not Ankara. Nirav.
Abuja.
Abuja's right. Nice job. 5 for you. So that means at the end of that round, Zeb has 80, Nirav has 75, William 60 crime bucks. Nice job, guys. That's the way to do that thing.
Brad, now, come into my office.
Yes, ma'am. I'll be right there. You guys stay here. I'm going to check on her. Probably ought to check that monitor, too. What's up, Chief?
Greg, does anything in this office seem strange to you?
Nope.
Use your deductive skills.
Oh, you got rid of that mouse, that dead mouse behind the wall.
No, Greg. This office has lost its color.
Well, Chief, did you pay the color bill?
What? There's no such thing as a bill for color.
Yes, there is, Chief. What? It came in the mail last month.
But I never saw it.
Well, because it's here. That's a color bill right there. See?
Well, it says here I have to send a check for 9 cents to the Department of Color and Tinting.
9 cents? Chief, that's more than I make in a week.
Well, listen, Greg, if the gumshoes find out we can't pay our bills, they're going to get discouraged. Now, what do you think we should do to keep their morale up so they'll stay on the trail of Carmen?
Well, Chief, I'll tell you this. We could make a deal. The gumshoe that captures Carmen Sandiego could get a trip to anywhere in North America.
Excellent idea.
Thanks, Chief. Oh, and wait, I think I still may have some color from the last animated clue. Take a look at this.
Oh, huh? That's much better. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Now, Chief, I want to remind you, be sure and pay the anti-helium bill. It's what? Due today.
What anti-helium bill?
Chief, the anti-helium bill that was due today. Oh, never mind. You probably already paid it anyway.
Greg, there is no such thing as an anti-helium bill.
It's right here. Here.
Greg, go away.
Yes, ma'am. That reminds me, I've still got to pay that anti-16-ton weight bill. Oh, there it is right there. Got to remember to pay that. It's due today, so. Okay, gumshoes, remember, we're still looking for Eartha and the bell. Fortunately for us, though, Acme Bugnet has just intercepted this phone conversation between Eartha and Carmen Sandiego. Watch.
I have this ringing in my ears, Carmen. I can't figure it out. It's the bell, Clapperhead. Acme can hear it, too. Disguise yourself as a bull and head for the bull ring at Campo Pequeño. It's in a port city on Europe's Atlantic coast. What if some matador comes after me with a sword? First of all, in this country, they don't kill bulls at bullfights. Good. I can't stand blood, especially my own. And secondly, the matador isn't the main bullfighter. The real star is the cavalero, who fights the bull on horseback. Me versus a guy on a horse? No problem. I'll clobber him.
Hey guys. Fellas, look. Hey, look. It's a joke.
Greg.
It's a TV joke. See, America, I'm okay.
Yeah.
I'm okay. It's okay. Everything's fine. Thank you. Little joke there. Okay, guys, name the city, if you will, please. Is it Paris, Barcelona, or Lisbon? Remember the clues that we heard? Bullring at Campo Pequeño, port city on Europe's Atlantic coast, and they don't kill bulls at bullfights in this country. Everybody's ready. Zeb, what do you say?
I say Barcelona.
Barcelona, Nirav.
I say Barcelona.
Barcelona, William.
I say Lisbon.
Lisbon, the answer we're looking for is Lisbon. Yeah! Nice job, Willie. Okay, so that means Zeb, you have 80, Nirav has 75, William 70 crime bucks. Nice.
Well, I've been chasing down a brute, creepy muscle-headed clown. Chasing down a brute in Michael Jordan's hometown. Chasing down a brute, creepy muscle-headed clown. Chasing down a brute in Michael Jordan's hometown. Wilmington is the name of the town. By the North Carolina, Cape Town. All right. They made two Ninja Turtle films there. Now squash that looks like a grip. Hey, don't you know I'm chasing down a brute, creepy muscle-headed clown. Chasing down a brute in Michael Jordan's hometown.
She stole that big beer. Now she thinks she's a Southern Belle.
I'm chasing down a brute creep, muscle-headed clown. Yeah.
Rockapella, ladies and gentlemen. Very nice. Thanks, guys. Thanks, Barrett. All right, Gumshoes, name the Atlantic Cape, if you will, please. Is it Cape Charles, Cape May, or Cape Fear? Remember the clues that we heard? Michael Jordan's hometown, Wilmington, and a North Carolina cape. Everybody's ready. Zeb, we'll start with you. What do you think?
I say Cape Charles.
Cape Charles. Nirav, what do you think?
I say Cape Fear.
Cape Fear. William?
I say Cape Charles.
Cape Charles. The answer we're looking for is Cape Fear. Nice job, Nirav. Okay, so Zeb, you have 80. Nirav moves up to 85. William, you have 70 crime bucks. Nice job, guys. Now, we've just heard that Eartha has left Cape Fear, so let's pick up the chase. All of these will be worth 5 crime bucks. Hands on your buzzers. Watch the monitor. Listen carefully. Here we go. Eartha chugged her chime to the capital of South Carolina. Name it. Nirav.
Columbia.
Columbia's right. She jet skied down the coast to Savannah. What state is she in? Nirav.
Georgia.
Georgia's right. She bulldozed her way due west across the border. What state is she in?
Alabama.
Zeb. What is it?
Alabama.
Alabama's right. She hung her bell at the site of the Civil War's Battle of Zeb.
Mississippi.
Mississippi's right. She rafted over to Louisiana. What river did she cross? Nirav.
Mississippi.
Mississippi's right. At the end of that round, then Zeb has 90. Nirav, 100. William, 70 crime bucks. Nice job, guys. All right. You guys have now made it. It's now time for the final clue of this round, which means you now have to decide how much you want to risk. If you're right, we'll add that amount to your score. If you're not right, we'll subtract it from your score. You can risk 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, or 50 Acme crime bucks. Take a look, if you will, please, right over here. Here's a portion of the world where we think Eartha is headed. Now, if you know a lot about this part of the world, you may want to risk a lot. If you don't know very much about it, though, you may not want to risk quite so much. So, take a look at the map and think about it.
Think about it, how much you're gonna make.
Okay, looks like everybody's ready. Now, for our last clue, we have a field report from John Larroquette of Acme Courtnet. Watch.
Gumshoes. I spotted Eartha in one of the world's largest cities. She was fighting 10 bulls at once in the world's largest bullfighting arena, and she was winning. Now, listen. I know she hid the bell in a park right behind the monument called Los Niños Héroes. It honors young cadets who died defending their school during a U.S. invasion in the 1840s. Trust me, that's where you'll find Eartha and the bell.
Thanks, John. Okay, guys, to what city did Eartha go? Is it Mexico City, Guatemala City, or San Salvador? Remember the clues that we heard? One of the world's largest cities, the world's largest bullfighting arena, and Los Niños Héroes monument. Okay, looks like everybody's ready. William, we're going to start with you. How much did you risk?
I risked 50 crime.
50 crime bucks. What'd you say?
I said Mexico City.
Mexico City is right. Nice job, William. Takes you up to 120. Zeb, you have 90 crime bucks. How much did you risk?
I risked 50 crime bucks.
50 crime bucks. What'd you say?
Mexico City.
Is right. Nice job. You're up to 140 crime bucks. Nirav, you have 100 crime bucks. How much did you risk?
20.
20 crime bucks. What'd you say?
Mexico City.
Mexico City is right. Okay, so that means, Zeb, you're definitely going on to the next round. Nirav and William, you're both tied with 120. We have to break that tie. Here's how we're going to do it. What I'm going to do is name a place. What you have to do is tell me what state that place is in. I'll keep naming places in that state until one of you buzzes incorrectly, okay? You can buzz as many times as you want to, okay? Listen carefully. Here we go. Mentor on the Lake, Gallipolis, Canton, Nirav.
Ohio.
Ohio is right. That means Nirav and Zeb, you're going on to the next round. Congratulations. William, listen, man, you are a great detective. You did some great things for us today. We've assembled a kit that's going to help you in your next case. Chief.
It's the official Acme Crime Net travel kit. It includes an atlas for world travelers, an official Carmen watch, a Carmen t-shirt, a subscription to National Geographic World magazine, and for quick reference when you're hanging on the rim, a portable globe. Good work.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, guys, now what you have to do is go to Mexico City to try to track down Eartha. You have to find her, bring back the bell. But, as you know, we do not send our agents out into the field unprepared. Chief, how about a briefing?
The boys down at Photo Recon have put together a few slides on Mexico City. Now, Mexico City has about 20 million people. It's going to be a heck of a place to find the bruiser and the bell. So, they put together this to help you out. Is the bell behind this bronze bruiser's ball? He stands in front of the Aztec soccer stadium, one of the world's largest. It can seat around 100,000 fans. Take a detour to the ancient Aztec city of Tenochtitlan. See if Eartha's hanging out at the Temple of Quetzalcoatl. We've got a few informants there. Now, yes, I know, they look like wall ornaments, but that one on the lower left is actually a cleverly disguised Acme agent. Back to Mexico City. Now, if you need to grab a bite, grab a tortilla. Thin, round patties of pressed corn flour cooked on a grill, then wrapped around just about any kind of food, and you've got a great portable meal. No, it's not a teensy little bull. It's a really big ring. Mexico City's bullfighting arena seats 50,000 spectators, and, well, we found what we think may be Eartha's ticket. It says, I'll... 49, seat 17. And you know what? I think that's her, you see. Right over there in the far section. Yes, that the one in the red t-shirt. But I can't be sure. Now, go make a positive ID on her gumshoes. Eartha Brute has taken the Tsar Bell to Mexico City. Go get her.
All right, guys, here we are in Mexico City. Set your stuff down right here. Take a walk right over that way. Let me show you what we have. Here are the possible locations where you will be able to find Eartha, the bell, and a warrant for Eartha's arrest. Now, the first thing you have to do is find the loot. That's the evidence you need so that you can get the warrant. With the warrant, you can then arrest the crook. Now, connect all three of those things in that order in a single turn, and you get a chance to try to catch Carmen Sandiego. Catch Carmen Sandiego, and you get that trip to anywhere in North America. One more thing, as always, if you happen upon the loot, the warrant, or the crook, you get a free turn, okay? Zeb, you are ahead at the end of the last round. You go first.
Can I see University City?
Yes, you may. University City. Nothing there. Okay.
Plaza no. Mexico.
Plaza Mexico. Sorry, nothing there. Zeb.
Polanco.
Polanco.
Ransom Ringer.
Nice job. You got the loot. You're on the right track. You get a free turn. Go ahead.
Ministry of Education.
Ministry of Education.
The warrant.
You, sir, have the loot. You now have the warrant. You get a free turn. If you can find Eartha, you've done it. Go ahead.
Aztec Stadium.
Aztec Stadium. Is she there? No, she's not. Sorry, we're going to turn these back around. Nirav, your turn.
Volcano.
Polanco.
Chisel Chimer.
Go ahead, Nirav.
Ministry of Education.
Ministry of Education.
The warrant.
You have the loot, you have the warrant, and same thing. Can you find her?
Central Post Office.
Central Post Office. Is she there? No, she's not. Sorry, we'll turn these back around. Zeb, your turn.
Polanco.
Polanco.
Ministry
of Education. Now go, Zeb.
Ministry of Education.
Ministry of Education.
And the warrant.
You have the loot, you have the warrant, you need
National
one more.
Palace.
Go ahead, Zeb.
National
what?
Palace.
National Palace. Sorry, we're going to turn them back around. Nirav, go ahead.
Polanco.
Polanco.
The bells are ringing for me and my Tsar.
Go ahead.
Ministry of Education.
Ministry of Education.
The warrant.
You have the loot, you have the warrant, we need one more. What is
Leon
it going to be?
Leon Trotsky House.
What is it?
Leon Trotsky.
Leon Trotsky House. No, it's not at the Russian Russian's house. Go ahead, Zeb.
Polanco.
Polanco.
Russian bells, Milford all the way.
I love this part. Go, Zeb.
Ministry of Education.
Ministry of Education.
And
the warrant.
Now, Zeb.
And El Centro.
El Centro. No, sorry, nothing there. Okay, turn it back around. Nirav, you know where you're going to go.
Polanco.
Polanco.
Go, Nirav.
Go ahead.
Ministry of Education.
Ministry of Education.
The warrant.
You have the loot, you have the warrant, need one more.
Lagunilla Market.
Lagunilla Market. No, sorry. Go ahead, Zeb.
Polanco.
What a surprise, Polanco.
Go Zeb.
Go ahead, Zeb.
Ministry of Education.
Ministry of Education.
And the Warren.
Need one more.
Rhino Aventura.
Rhino Aventura. No, sorry, nothing there. We're turning them around.
Polanco.
Polanco.
Ministry
I like that
of
one.
Education.
I'm sorry, go ahead, Nirav. What?
Ministry of Education.
Ministry of Education.
Diego.
The Warren.
Now go.
Diego Rivera Museum.
Diego Rivera Museum. Is Eartha there? Yeah!
You won! Woo!
Come here, Nirav. You look overwhelmed and out of control. Okay, now what you have to do is put Eartha in jail, pull on the chain, do it.
In jail.
Here you go, buddy. Now listen, we're gonna talk about your next adventure just a little bit. First off, Zeb, listen, you were a great detective. You tracked Eartha all the way here. We have something very special for you. Chief.
You never know when you'll need a fast fact. That's why we equip our gumshoes with a portable electronic encyclopedia. It takes only seconds to scan the complete rundown on any topic. Ecuador or the space probe, Galileo or the Amazon, it's high-tech help in hooking heinous hooligans. Congratulations.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, you got Eartha. Now we're going to try to catch Carmen Sandiego. If you catch her, you get the trip. But what we want to know is where you want to go if you do that. Inside here, there's a piece of paper. There's also a pen. Open it up and do it.
Where do you want to go?
So, all right, now what you have to do is find Carmen Sandiego. We're not sure where she's gone, but usually we get a phone call on that, and we have once again. Hello? Yeah, he's right here. It's for you.
Hello?
This is Eartha Brute calling. All I do here in jail is split rocks. I've never been so happy in all my life. Bring Carmen over to share the fun. You'll find her in Europe.
What'd she say?
She's in Europe.
Okay, so you and I are going to Europe. Chief!
Here's a list of places Carmen may have traveled.
Portugal, Northern Ireland, Scotland, Netherlands, France, Malta, Moldova, Austria, Poland, Hungary, Albania, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Croatia. Greg, let's go to the map.
All right, you know what this is, right?
Yeah.
Okay, what you have to do now is track Carmen Sandiego through 8 different countries, identifying each one with a marker. When you are right, you will hear this sound. But if by chance you're wrong, you'll hear this sound. It's very important. If you hear that sound 2 times, leave the marker where it is, come on back, and we'll continue. But if you're right, 8 times in 45 seconds, you will then win that trip. How will you feel?
Happy.
I think so. Oh, and I believe you so much. How will you guys feel? Yeah, come on, Nero. Let's do this thing. Come on. Let's get 45 seconds up on the clock. Good luck to you. You guys cheer him on. Here we go, Nero. On your mark. Get set. Go. Carmen went to Portugal. Portugal. Good. Yeah, come on. Austria. Yeah. Scotland. Go, buddy. Come on. Yes. Malta. Come on, buddy. Hurry. No, try it again. No. Malta, hurry. Gotta hurry. Hurry. No, come on back. Hungary. Yeah. Northern Ireland. Yes. Albania. Oh. Did he get this one in time? No, he didn't. You got 5 and 45 seconds. Not bad. Give him a hand, you guys. Listen, man, I'll tell you, sometimes Carmen's just tough to catch, but remember, you got the loot, you got the crook. That's not bad, Chief. What do you say?
You've done great work today, and we're proud of you. I hereby upgrade you. You are now a sleuth. Congratulations!
Nice job, buddy. And now that you are a sleuth, that gives you the right to also wear the official Carmen Sandiego sleuth jacket. Very nice. Good job. Yeah, we may have to get you a bigger one. That's okay. How do you feel?
Happy.
You said you would, and you do. Good. Listen, you've been doing some great stuff for us today. There's one more thing I want you to do. You know what it is?
Here, Rockefeller.
Well, she sneaks around the world from Vienna to Carolina. She's licking finger filcher from Berlin down to Belize. She'll take you for a ride on a longboat to China. Tell me,
where in the world is
Carmen Sandiego?
Steal their
soul in South Korea. Maybe let it come right on the from the Red Sea to Greenland. They'll be singing the blues. Well, they never Arkansas her steal from me. Come from the jungle.
Where in the world is
Carmen Sandiego?
She drove from Nashville to Norway, Van Andrews, Zimbabwe, Chicago to Czechoslovakia
and back.
Well, she'll rent and Pakistan and run a scan in Scandinavia. Then she'll stick her phone down under and go big pocket first. She was Miss and Miss Nina when she stole the beat from Lima. Tell me,
where in the world is
Carmen Sandiego?
Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
Speaking for Where in the World, it's Carmen Sandiego. And remember, we bust up evil, thieving rackets. Plus, we wear these snappy jackets. All contestants have been